The Rape of the Lock by Alexander Pope. Character List: Belinda. The character of Belinda is the heroine of The Rape of the Lock. Pope bases her character on the historical Arabella Fermor, the daughter of an aristocratic Catholic family. Robert, Lord Petre, a family friend, snipped a lock of her hair without permission, thereby causing a rift between their two families. Pope depicts this incident in the poem. The Baron is an admirer of Belinda's, and he enacts the rape of the lock by cutting off one of the curls of hair that hung down her neck. He is based on the historical Robert, Lord Petre. Carol, though Carol is not so much a character in the poem, he is mentioned only in line 3, he is the dedicatee of the poem. Carol is John Carol, a friend of Pope's who witnessed the incident between Arabella Fermor and Lord Petre. He commissioned Pope to turn the incident into a jest in the hope that it would encourage reconciliation between the two families. Clarissa is one of the women in attendance at the Hampton Court party. She is complicit in the severing of Belinda's hair, lending her sewing scissors to the Baron. She later delivers a moralizing sermon on the ephemeral nature of beauty and the importance of good sense once a woman's looks have faded. Ariel is Belinda's guardian sylph. Once a coquettish woman during his human life, he is now an air spirit who protects virginal women with the aid of an army of sylphs. Pope takes the sprite's name from the character in Shakespeare's The Tempest. Umbriel is a mischievous gnome, who travels to the cave of spleen and returns with a bag of sighs and a vial of tears which he uses to intensify Belinda's despair at the loss of her hair. Thales tries is Belinda's friend. She tries to convince Belinda to avenge the Baron's affront to her honor and is the most vicious aggressor in the battle over the lock. Appropriately, Pope takes her name from an Amazonian queen of Greek mythology. Summary: Belinda arises to prepare for the day's social activities after sleeping late. Her guardian sylph, Ariel, warned her in a dream that some disaster will befall her, and promises to protect her to the best of his abilities. Belinda takes little notice of this oracle, however. Ritual of dressing and primping. She travels on the Thames River to Hampton Court Palace, an ancient royal residence outside of London, where a group of wealthy young socialites are gathering for a party. Among them is the Baron, who has already made up his mind to steal a lock of Belinda's hair. He has risen early to perform an elaborate set of prayers and sacrifices to promote success in this enterprise. When the partygoers arrive at the palace, they enjoy a tense game of cards, which Pope describes in mock heroic terms as a battle. This is followed by a round of coffee. Then the Baron takes up a pair of scissors and manages, on the third try, to cut off the coveted lock of Belinda's hair. Belinda is furious. Umbriel, a mischievous gnome, journeys down to the cave of spleen to procure a sack of sighs and a flask of tears, which he then bestows on the heroine to fan the flames of her ire. Clarissa, who had aided the Baron in his crime, now urges Belinda to give up her anger in favor of good humor and good sense, moral qualities which will outlast her vanities. But Clarissa's moralizing falls on deaf ears, and Belinda initiates a scuffle between the ladies and the gentlemen, in which she attempts to recover the severed curl. The lock is lost in the confusion of this mock battle, however, the poet consoles the bereft Belinda with the suggestion that it has been taken up into the heavens and immortalized as a constellation.